This is Angelos Martinos.
I miss the body catcher, slaughter gang soul snatcher. Ain't no regular F-150, it's a fucking rapper.
From the blue corner, nigga, not a rapper. Angelos
Martinos sprints out to the ring, Ultimate Warrior style, with the Greek flag draped over his shoulders. The 21-year-old out of the Fighters Factory, Karousos, 28-3, record 8 knockouts. He will have 7 centimetres height over Tato tonight. Comes in off a career-high performance, winning the ISKA lightweight world title in France against Jonathan Main by split decision. Gunji has been ranked in the top 10 pound-for-pound kickboxers in the world since 2021. Comes in on an amazing 11-fight win streak, dating back to December 2020. He disposed easily of one championship fighter, Wang Zhongwang. Back-to-back wins over Thais. He beat Dawn Sayam, Wor Wachai, and former Channel 7 Stadium champion, Yu Petkason. The former Crush Bantamweight champion, K1 Featherweight champion, K1 Featherweight World Grand Prix winner. Tato Gunji, a fan favorite. We're about to see something very special, Mike.
Yes, definitely. So Tato Gunji, incredible record. I mean, this guy's been at it for so long and at the top of the sport for so long as well. I mean, he came in, he announced himself, and at 22 years of age, he won the featherweight title straight out of the gate. Incredible, incredible talent in Tato Gunji.
24 years old, 23-5-1 record, Tato Gunji. He won the Crush Bantamweight title in 2017. A decision win over Rusei. Gunji has never lost to a foreign opponent. He's beaten 3 Thais. He's beaten Chinese opponents. He's also has a win over Argentina's Farco Suarez last year. And this is Japan versus Greece.
延長1ラウンド. 青コーナー 174cm 57.1kg ギリシャ. FFK ポリティスチーム ISKA 世界ライト級王者アンジェロス・マルティナス。赤コーナー167cm 57.4kg 日本 K1 事務総本部チームペガサス第5代 K1 ワールドグランプリフェザー級王者軍事タイト。ジャッジ山根正美、箱崎雄三、山崎明、レフェリー梅木義則。
Final instructions from our center referee. There was a distinct swagger about Angelos Martinos yesterday at the press conference. He does have experience on paper over Tato Gunji, but when it comes to caliber of opposition he's faced, Gunji has it all. First round of action, they touch gloves. A featherweight super fight set for 3x3, one extra round in case of a draw. Martinos continuing a proud tradition of Greek fighters in K1 history. The likes of Stan the Man Longanides, Tarsus Tosca Petridis, and of course, Iron Mike Zambides. Inside leg kick from Tato Gunji. Martinos has a very good right cross on him. If he can get it off here on Gunji. Gunji's hands up. high as well. They should be here, Mike.
Yeah, I mean, you have to imagine. He's just in there gaining input. I mean, I'm imagining that Gunji's just looking him up and down like the Terminator, ready to dispatch at a moment's notice.
Outside leg kick from Martinos. If there is one thing that has always characterized Greek kickboxers, it is the left hook. And let's see what left hook Martinos possesses. Zambidis was renowned for his stand the man longanides. It was his patented left hook that won him so many fights. Outside leg kick there from Martinos. Handling himself well so far in the opening minute 15. Body shot from Taito Gunji.
It's almost like you're in there, Michael. I mean, he's throwing those left hooks immediately after you set it.
Shot to the 6 o'clock there on Taito Gunji. That's a little too serious, but he will get a moment here to shake the old John Smalls back into place. Make sure everything is situated correctly. Martinos gives him a little nod in apology. Just the top of the ankle, the bottom of the shin connecting to the cup of Taito Gunji. And we're okay to go on here in the first round. Angelos Martinos has to try and use the reach advantage. You can see the length in the arms on the Greek fighter. 7 centimeters taller than Taito Gunji. 5'7", Martinos. 5'4", Gunji. Body shots from Gunji. Nice knee! Folds him with the knee! He folded him with the knee! Was it a groin strike? I thought it hit the body.
I couldn't see it from this angle, but my goodness, he just went right down.
Wow!
I'm going to imagine that that's a low blow just based on the way that the ref is looking at him.
There's no count by the referee, and Gunji is clutching the private parts. Let's have a look here. Yeah, so it looks like it's gone to the groin and then ridden up. From our angle, it looks like it's connected to the body, but it's a groin strike here. Second groin strike by Martinos in the last 60 seconds. Both accidental, there's no malice in them at all, but still, this one's slightly harder, I dare say, than the first.
Certainly. I mean, we're into most of this round being breaks for groin strikes right now. So, yeah, let's hope we can regroup with this. I don't know how much time he has to recover because that was a relatively hard shot. So hopefully it doesn't shift the angle of this match too much.
It shifted the angle of something, Mike. I won't say what, but I'm sure you can gather.
We felt it from up here.
Gunji just shaking everything back into place. The second strike south of the border that Taito Gunji has taken in this round. The man from Itabashi in the Tokyo metropolis. 23-5-1 record, 6 knockouts, a 26% KO ratio for the K-1 featherweight champion. K-1 featherweight World Grand Prix winner. Certainly though, Martinos could not afford a third groin strike against Gunji. Good outside leg kick from the Greek. Body shot from Gunji.
I was going to say, he's probably on thin ice at this point. I mean, after two body shots, first of all, Taito Gunji's pretty pissed off.
Have a look at Martinos, though. Not afraid to stand toe-to-toe and juke it out with Taito Gunji. He wants to be inside the phone booth, does the Greek. Not backing away from the rapid-fire hand combinations of Taito Gunji.
No, he's not messing around right now. He's ready to bang.
Body shots from Gunji. Good left hand. Martinos gets back to center ring. Body shots again from Gunji, battering both sides of the carcass. And just a slip in center ring for Martinos. Gunji's got speed. Liver shot from an outside thigh kick. Martinos goes high. Looping left hand from Martinos to a front kick. Rib kick there from Martinos. Right hand collects him on the orbital. Overhand right from Gunji. End of the round, a torrid round for the testicular area of Taito Gunji. And not not a bad first impression from Angelo Smartino.
No, shocking to be honest with you. I mean, I was not seeing that coming, but he really stepped in, and the second half of that round was as good as I've seen today. They really went toe-to-toe. Incredible.
The speed and the technique. It's what K1 Max back in the day. As pound for pound, the greatest era in kickboxing. Mike, if you were in the corner of Taito Grunji, what are you telling me 24-year-old for 2 minutes round?
I mean, he hasn't done much in the way of wrong. I think he's unfortunately had had some low blows that have taken the wind out of his sails a little bit, but hopefully he's had some time to bounce back from that. And now going into the second round, hopefully he can get back up to speed and really make his mark.
Ksipna. Second round of action. Gunji staring down Martinos from across the ring. It is a featherweight super fight. And Martinos continue the momentum he had in the first round. Nice left hand to outside fly kick combination. It really is the bread and butter technique they teach you in your first kickboxing class, jab to leg kick. And it doesn't matter what level you are, Mike, whether you're amateur or elite, it works every time. Jab, leg kick, the old one, you know, the old jab, bread and butter, leg kick combination. We saw Hoos do it in the day, we saw Ertz do it in the day, Semi Schulte used to do it in the day, Andy Sauer was a big component of it back in the day as well.
I mean, yeah, of course, you got to go bread and butter. It's what's been working forever. Some of these guys get very fancy with things, but at the end of the day, you do those two things right, and you just knock people out.
Although in Martinos's case, it might be more bread and tzatziki. Ground kicks there from both men. Gunji, right hand lead, left over the top, solid work. Good counter right hand from Martinos. A lot of people thought that Angelos Martinos would be out of his depth today at Yokohama Arena. You saw the highlight reel. You saw the small regional shows that Martinos has been a part of over in Europe. But he is really taking it up to Taito Gunji. Gunji getting backed up by that right hand leg kick combination.
Yeah, if anything, I mean, it really speaks to the scouters of K1 that they were able to go out and find someone of this caliber, relatively unknown, but my goodness, he's really gone in there and is laying into Taito Gunji right now.
Gunji on the inside, step across outside, thigh kick that lead leg, front kick off the lead leg from Gunji. Martinos fakes the low kick. Martinos coming off a great year in 2022, had back-to-back wins over Lumbus Dingas and Becca Gabasanoya. Right hand from Martinos. Big right hand again, sat down on that one. Just testing the jaw of Gunji. Checks the low kick. Right hand again, backs up Gunji. Gunji trying to explode forward with these rapid fire combinations. Martinos again sticks in with that right hand once more, curls it around the back of the left glove. There's the right hand again to the kisser.
Oh, they're just throwing it so well. I mean, honestly, Martinos is just really in there, just leathering it.
Good overhand left from Taito Gunji. Martinos knees on the inside. There's one from Gunji, and it's a return favor. Here is your strike to the nether regions.
And there's the receipt. I mean, you had to imagine it was coming in. But we made it halfway into, or more than halfway into the second round at this point before this became an issue. But
well, it must have been the bottom of the shin riding up and connecting to the Greek Kalamata olives of Angelos Martinos, because the knee hit him in the midsection.
It didn't look intentional. I mean, none of these have been with malice necessarily. But yeah, I mean, it's unfortunate to keep disrupting the flow of an unbelievable fight.
I've got to say, it is my first time seeing Martinos by Mike, and I am impressed.
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, I did not see it coming. He's out of nowhere, and here we go.
Taito Gunji! More combinations than a Sudoku puzzle. And look at the counter right hand from Martinos, now toe-to-toe. Gunji gets on the inside with the right hand. And Martinos goes back down. Toe-to-toe they go. What a way to win that round.
Hell of a round, my goodness, right at the end. dozens of punches. What a great, great fight we have here as a setup for even more fights for this K1 GP tonight.
I have a drop kick from Martinos. Looping Matan to a straight right cross from Gunji. Martinos backed him off afterwards. Tremendous result from Angelos Martinos. One more round to go. Gunji taking a stall in his corner. Martinos standing. Do you ever read anything into that mind? One fighter stands, one fighter sits.
You have to imagine. I mean, this definitely is adding up. I mean, they've had some serious issues going into this. I mean, Gunji's been rattled around a little bit. So it doesn't surprise me to see him sit down for a moment, collect his thoughts, but I don't know. I think he's ready to throw.
Third and final round of this K1 featherweight super fight. Taito Gunji, Angelos Martinos, Japan versus Greece from inside the Yokohama Arena. Martinos comes out with the jabs. Gunji with the leg kick. Good outside thigh kick from Martinos. Gunji on the outside early here. Martinos again scoring with those leg kicks. Jab two falls short. Body shot tucks it under the elbow. Does Martinos. Outside leg kick almost buckled that lead leg of Gunji. Overhand right from Martinos. Gunji backs him off with a right. Martinos needs to go back to that lead leg, Mike.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. He's making a massive statement right here. 21 years old. What technique.
This unknown Greek fighter, never heard of outside of Greece, is making a name for himself in Japan today at K1 Rebirth. Takes a front kick. Eats that left hand. Gunji sitting against the ropes. There's the leg kick again. Tenderizing the quad. Now goes the inside thigh. That lead leg of Gunji looks like it's been sunburned. It is reddened from the leg kicks of Angelos Martinos.
Yeah, I mean, Gunji really has to step up. He's only got a minute 43 right now, and it's not looking good. He's throwing wildly. That lead leg is banged up.
Martinos has got to go back to the legs to slow down the boxing of Taito Gunji. That's how you stop a puncher. That's how you stop a boxer. You take out their legs. Big right hand from Gunji.
On cue, he responds.
All good punches start from the soles of the feet. Come up through the legs, power through the body, through the arm and out through the knuckles. If you can take out a puncher's legs, you effectively close down their boxing ability.
Yeah, you got it right there. I mean, Gunji is, he's throwing bombs, but they're not as solid as they were in the earlier rounds. He just doesn't have the ability right now. He's so shot with that leg.
That said, the last 45 seconds or so, Taito Gunji has lifted the pace. Martinos is going to bring it home strongly now for the final 45 seconds. He's got to go back to that lead thigh. Rocks the head back to Gunji. Goes the liver. Step through knee. Martinos takes another groin strike. I think the groin count is 2-2 now.
This fight, unfortunately, is going to remember for groin strikes, amongst other not so good things. But I mean, this was a real come out for Martinos in a lot of different ways. But yeah, I mean, the flow has really been disrupted right here, just consistently.
So again, I think it's the top of the shin hitting the cup of Martinos, because the knee was landed flush to the abdomen of the Greek fighter. Remember the old days, Mike, when someone got a really bad groin strike and the doctor would come in and have the towel? They'd surround them with a towel and the old trunks would go down and the doctor's hand would come out, and you can imagine the rest. You know it was always bad when the towel came out?
I try not to think about it, but yeah, absolutely. This is one of those days where you'd imagine it, the towel would be coming out. This would be a
you do not want the towel to emerge. So still on the third and final round of what has been an amazing contest. Martinos has got to go back to the lead leg of Gunji. Gunji backs him up with rapid fire techniques again. He wants a boxing contest on the inside. Wants to stay in the pocket as Taito Gunji. Martinos, good harpoon of a right hand. Left hook from the Greek. Gunji step through knee. Best round of the fight so far for Taito Gunji.
Is it enough? He's got 7 seconds to prove it. I think he needs a knockdown.
Outside leg kick Gunji. And a head kick from Angelos Martinos. There have been some very tight decisions tonight. Mike, that said, I would not be surprised if this one's called an extra round.
That's a very good point. And even right at the end of that, Martinos put his stamp on Taito Gunji's face with a little bit of a quick kick, quick little snap right there. But yeah, this is one that could definitely go to another round, and I'd love to see it, just minus any groin strikes.
Judge Yamazaki, 30 tai, 30 draw.
There's one draw.
Judge Yamazaki, 30 tai, 29. Aka Gunji.
One for Gunji.
Judge Yamane, 30 tai, 20. Aka Gunji. 以上判定2対0をもちまして勝者アカコーナー、
so、Gunji edges it.
Taito.
That is heartbreaking for Angelos Martinos, but I'm sure we'll be seeing much more of this Greek fighter. Himself exceptionally well. But Taito Gunji comes away with the win. The boxing work particularly in the third round of Gunji takes his record now to 24-5-1. Does the 24-year-old from Itabashi in Tokyo. Folks, strap yourselves in, because coming up next, semi-final number one, the grizzly Claudio Estrade, who obliterated Mahmoud Sattari in the quarterfinals, will take on the Tower of Power, the hero of Iran, Sina Karimian. And then, semi-final number two, what happens when Ariel Machado, the smallest competitor remaining in the tournament, takes on the man that Eddie Bravo dubbed the Chinese Ivan Drago, Liu Sa. Our semi-finals are coming up next.